Hey, Michael Zlapsky here for a Tip Tuesday, and I'm going to talk to you today about motion paths in Trapcode Particular. There's some confusion about what they'll do and what they're for, and hopefully this quick little look into them will break it down for you. So we've got a composition with Trapcode Particular at defaults, and I've got a light named Motion Path 1 that's moving around over the course of about 2 seconds. Now, motion paths in particular are in the displace category under motion path, and you can pick from 1 till 9. It depends on what your light is named. So you can have up to 9 different motion paths in your project. So we'll pick motion path 1, since that's the only one we've got going on here, and you'll see our particles are following the motion path. They're following the path of that light. Now, you'll notice that they start tight together and then move apart. And again, like I said, this is because this is in the displace category. So the movement following the light's movement happens after all this other stuff, like the velocity of the particles, for example. So if I turn this velocity down to 0, you'll see that the particles are now following exactly the movement of the light, and then just kind of stop. Now, I'm starting the light right where the particles are born, but what happens if the particles are born somewhere and that's not on the light path? I'm going to hit U to reveal my keyframes and scooch to this keyframe of the light, selecting all my keyframes by clicking on the property. Now, if you have all your keyframes selected and your current time indicator is sitting on a keyframe, you can drag and offset your keyframe values however you would like, and all of the keyframes will be offset, and you'll see my light path is now over here, but the particles, they're still following the same path from the same position. Why have they not moved? Well, the truth is, motion paths are just dictating the movement of the particles, not based off the position of the light, but based off the position of the particle. So they're not following the light's path, they're following the light's movement. So they take the first position of the light as their first position, wherever they happen to be born. They're like, right, here's our position, and then if the light moves 100 this way and 100 that way, well then the particles when they're born will move 100 this way and 100 that way. They'll basically follow the motion relative to their birth point. So I can demonstrate that if I change this from a point emitter to a box emitter, and we'll say it'll be XYZ individual. I'll make every value 1 except for the X. You'll see the particles are being born on a, 500 pixels left or right of this position here, and they just follow the movement of that light from wherever they're born. So they go around, up, and down, and forward, and, however that light moves, and then they just sit here. Because again, they have no movement other than that of the light, because it is just displacing them off their movement. If I, for example, go here into the environment category and crank up air turbulence affects position, you see the particles start moving off their path as they get older and older, because again, the displacement happens after all this happens. So you can use all this stuff together to get the exact movement you want, but knowing how it works is certainly helpful. Just remember, if you want your particles to follow a specific path, you have to put the emitter at the exact point of your light's first point, and then it'll follow the path exactly. But if you just want them to have the specific overall motion, you can do that as well. And what's really fun is if you've got a bunch of particles emitting from a bunch of different places, but following the same motion path, you get a really cool look.